football.
Yeah.
What up? It's the Trooper. Today is Tuesday, and I just had some of the best damn drunken noodles. Well, I gotta say, Archie's Bistro is really good, but I really like the drunken noodles here at Thai Street Action. So today, we continue the guide, not the guide, the Trooper's guide to Las Vegas poker rooms. I mean, you could call it the guide, but you can find some of this information elsewhere. But if you want to go in the casino like the Trooper, then this is the poker room guide. Quick little voicemail gate update, that rhymes. There's still confusion out there. I don't know why I should even continue to try to clarify the situation. There's the guy who left the voicemail last Thursday. I think I know who it is. There's a guy who used to make YouTube videos talking shit about me and being a real weirdo back in 2017. I know who that guy is. Now, I say I know who he is, and I do. But then I also say that I don't want him to know that I know who he is. Just a tiny little bit of logic will tell you that what I mean by that is that if I don't give you evidence that I know who it is, then he's gonna think I don't know who he is. I mean, this is a guy whose face was never on his videos, but I know who he is. If I give you evidence I know who he is, then he knows I know who he is. Is the guy from the videos in 2017 who I know who he is that the guy who left the voicemail? That's the part I don't know. I think it is, but I don't know for sure. The whole point here is that I put the voicemail out there so that maybe other people could say, oh snap, I recognize that voice. Nobody has come up with the name. Nobody's come up with the channel. People have made suggestions. None of those suggestions are correct. I understand why some people guessed some names, but those names are not correct. And I also said, and it is true, that person's YouTube videos have been deleted. The channel is gone. That's the entire update. Now we're gonna worry about what's up with that Resorts World poker room. What's the deal, yo? What's the deal with that Resorts World? Well, they have more games today than they had 2 days ago. At least it would appear. I just tried to put my name on the list using the Poker Atlas app. I was unsuccessful because I have a new phone and I have not set it up on my new phone. So as we break out this highly addictive, damn tasty strawberry margarita sparkly pop, allow me to inform you that the Resorts World Casino does indeed have a parking garage. Matter of fact, they have more than one. The garages are set up to charge for parking, but they've never charged for parking. There may have been one time during some sort of event where they were charging for parking, but if you had a player's card for the casino, you did not have to charge for parking. The poker room assured me months ago that if you play poker here, you will not pay for parking. Things change. I don't know how things are going for Resorts World overall as a property. I do know that some restaurants have already closed, but I also know they have opened new outlets to the food court. The food court here is a little different. You find a screen and you go through the screen and you order things from multiple outlets or whatever you want. Maybe you want the thing over here, the thing over there, maybe you want both. You pay cashless, they don't accept cash. You gotta pay with a card. And then you get a text on your phone when your food is ready. Funny thing about that is, last time I was here anyway, you were not able to use poker comps for those outlets. I have no idea why, okay? You could use your comps at the burger, lobster burger, or whatever the hell it is right across in the poker room. Oh, but that place closed. Across from that, in the little sports bar thing, there's like a grilled cheese truck. You could use your comps for that. I assume it's still there. I haven't been in here in a long time. You can use your poker comps for Mulberry Street Pizza. One of my favorite things about the Resorts World Poker Room is that right around the corner from it, there is a 24-hour Starbucks. The other thing that I love about it is that mobile order is in play. Whip out the Starbucks app, put in your order, pay with your card, you don't have to do nothing, just show up and get the coffee. Games, 2 2-5 games and 2 5-10 games at the moment at Resorts World. My game just got very short, so we're taking a short break while players maybe arrive and maybe don't arrive, who knows. Actually, now I see a player from my table walking as if he's leaving, so I don't know, my game may be breaking. They also have a $5 Bomb Pot PLO game going, and they also have 8-16 limit and 80-160 limit going, and also something called Crazy Mike's. I don't know, it's $30,000 plus. I don't know what the blinds are, or it's a mixed game, so I don't know. The max rake at Resorts World is $5, and I am 99.99999% sure that they do not have promotions here. They do have daily tournaments. $160 tournament every day at noon and at 7 p.m. I almost played the tournament today, but I wasn't in the mood for a time commitment. We're gonna see. Oh, I put too much cream. I forgot. I just got a blonde Americano and it's much lighter. I think I put too much cream, y'all. Little too much cream. I'm gonna live with it though. If I go back here and my game is not currently running, if hands are not being dealt, I'm leaving. I'm gonna go on a, what's up?
How you doing, man?
Good, how are you? I'm gonna go on a covert operation. That's right, covert. And then depending on what I find, I might go on an overt operation. Thank you. would appear that one of the 5-10 games turned into a 10-20 game. I failed to mention earlier that the comps that you receive while playing poker, it's $1.50 an hour. I noticed a new burger place in the food court over there. I believe it used to be the place that had the chicken parm sandwich or whatever, but they have burgers now. Looks like a burger's around $10 or $11, and then fries is about $6, $5 or $6. So that's kind of in line with a lot of the casinos on the strip. I have no idea what the burger is like or how it tastes or any of that. Maybe I'll have to try a burger soon. Let me check my rearview mirror over here. I end up winning $412 for the night, in for $300, out for $712. There's a guy in a Tesla down there trying to make a three-point turn in a spot where it looks like there's no room to make a three-point turn. The buy-in at 1-3 is 100 to 400. The buy-in at 2-5 is 200 to 1200. Weird, right? I don't know what the min buy-in is at 5-10. I want to say 400. The max is 3,000. And yeah, they have some kind of Crazy Mike's big, you know, limit game that goes in the little glass room in there. The poker cage is currently closed at Resorts World, I assume to save labor. They just sell you chips right at the desk now, but they were saying they hope they have the poker cage back during the World Series of Poker. Now, what's this guy doing? There's an awful lot of traffic, cars driving on these, all this shit's closed. I guess maybe this is a Resorts World person or something. So anyway, that other car pulling up was actually security making sure that I wasn't a crazy person. So it's 81 degrees out here, a little bit of a breeze going. I decided that it was a nice night to take the outside route back to the car, back to the Trooper Mobile. Told you they were addictive. This is a regular margarita. Overall, I like the Resorts World Poker Room. The chairs are very comfortable. The staff, I like the staff. That's gonna do it. That's gonna do it. It's quiet out here. It's echoey. Whoa. Hello. Whoop. What up? Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. Look at me. Am I serious? I'm serious about that. I'm gonna see you next time.